I was coaching, I was a pitching coach at Biola University, kind of one of my first collegiate coaching jobs. I had come off playing professionally at the time and kind of in between professional and college ranks and wanted to get into coaching, was coaching with the baseball program, and the athletic director at Biola came to me and said, "Hey, we're starting our softball program. Would you be interested in taking over the program?" I talked with a few people. You know, they said the game is great. It's fast. It's quick paced. I love that you could get a doubleheader in about 3 hours. So I thought, what the heck? Let's try it. Best decision I made. Fell in love with the game. Talked with a lot of people. Went to some coaching clinics. And like I said, really just fell in love with the game.
Hey, here we go. Have some fun, man. Get that pitch. I just want to make sure we're on the same page. If we run a steal stop here, we know what we're doing, right? You know what we're doing in this situation? We got two strikes. You're the tying run right there. We can't get picked off. I like being aggressive, but you got to know when is aggressive, okay?
I got a phone call from Sue Inquist from UCLA, kind of the John Wooden of college softball, and wanted to know if the Ole Miss job would interest me. And I said, yeah, I'd love to coach in the SEC. And so, you know, really, I think within a day later, I think I got a phone call from Lynette Johnson that said my name had kind of been mentioned. You know, would I be interested in coming up and going on an interview? And brought the family up, spent a couple days here, interviewed for it. This was my ultimate goal, to coach in one of the Big Five conferences. And of course, you know, now coaching in the SEC, the big leagues of college softball. So, you know, it was about a week and a half later that I got the phone call. Loved everything that Ole Miss had to offer. Loved where the direction, the future of the program, knowing that this was a place that I could build something special.
Hey, same passion, same energy that we had yesterday, okay?
I guarantee if you move around, you'll stay warm. That's why I'm in shorts.
This new coaching staff, they have absolutely turned my attitude around because they believe in me. They believe in this team, and they believe in every single one of the pitchers, every one of the hitters, and they believe in me. And to have someone to believe in me, you would think, you know, you think that you can motivate yourself, but you don't know until you don't have that motivation. You don't realize how much just someone believing in you helps.
Well, I think the first thing is that the players have to have a belief in themselves because they're going to get it from their coaching staff. They have to know that we're behind them 100%. They have to have that faith and belief that their coaching staff is going to believe in them. And it doesn't mean that we don't believe in them if they're not the everyday starter, they don't get the pinch hit. And I think that's the first thing.
And I was actually excited to know that there was going to be this type of coaching atmosphere and energy and enthusiasm and passion that he was going to bring to the table. And even the other coaches too, they just have such a passion for this game that really rubs off on all of us. And I think people can tell when we're out there playing that it's really put a change and a transformation on this team.
I feel like he knows all of us a lot better than, you know, we thought he would, and he's gotten to kind of like shock us by little things that he does that make us excited for things like the blue uniforms that we were like, "Whoa, this is awesome."
How are they?
They're awesome, huh? They're pretty sweet, huh? They're pretty sweet.
I'm gonna go play right now.
Awesome. They're pretty sweet,
Let's
huh?
Let's go play. Let's go to Arizona tonight.
So I wanted to do the special for you guys. I wanted to do something different for this first year that we're here. So I wanted to add some of that tradition. The second thing is about getting better every day. It's that one, we talk about 1%, and that was something that seemed very small, but attainable. It's an attainable goal. If you can get 1% better than you were the day before, I mean, how great can you be by the end of the season? So I think that was a culture. I think a culture too was to create some discipline, some structure. We can have a good time, but we also have a focus on what we're trying to do. And so to be able to give them those boundaries, without them being able to be free to be able to do some things for themselves. And I think that's it. I'm doing what I love to do. I get a chance to be around great student athletes and great coaches and, you know, mingle with just people that love athletics. And that's what excites me each and every day. 18 years later, I'm coaching at Ole Miss and humbled to be here and really looking forward to the future of our program.